I am in Oklahoma today at this triple shipping container home. It is made up of 3 40-foot containers plus an outdoor deck. We're also right across the street from this huge lake. Let's now go hop into the tour and check this place out. Welcome to this triple shipping container home. We are located in a quiet suburb in northeastern Oklahoma today. If we get a little closer, you'll see the slick black paint job and then the large outdoor deck on the second floor. If you go to the side of the home, you can see the 3 containers more clearly and then the part of the home that is bumped out for a bedroom and now the deck on the other side. We are also right across the street from Ologa Lake. It is a huge 30,000 acre lake with 11 lakeside parks, so there's a lot to do in the area. But that's it for everything outside. Let's go and check out the interior. When you first enter, you'll notice it's a very open floor plan. In this main room, you have a sitting area, your kitchen, your dining table, and the family room. In the sitting area, you have these 4 chairs that surround this round table. All of the colors match the hardwood flooring perfectly. There's also a nice guest book here that the host left behind for you. It was my first time in the state of Oklahoma, so I was not familiar with the area at all, but this entire book was very helpful. Information on the home itself, and also a bunch of stuff you can do in the surrounding area. So definitely give this a read through when you check in. Moving along, we'll go into the fully equipped kitchen next. You have all of your major appliances here, like your microwave, stovetop and oven, and coffee maker. There's also a dishwasher in this kitchen. And further down at the end, you have a nice stainless steel fridge and freezer with a water dispenser in it. So everything you could possibly need for your stay. Next, we'll head in this direction and you can see we're staring straight down a 40-foot container. This will take us into your dining area. You have a large dining table with enough seating for up to 6 guests here. You also have your air conditioning unit in this area and a bunch of nice decorations. I'll also definitely mention that the Wi-Fi was really on point here at this container home, so I was able to get all of my work done after shooting. We'll now exit the dining area and go past the table to come into the family room. You have these 2 large blue couches with a bunch of extra pillows and blankets and your coffee table in the middle, so plenty of seating options. There's also a few plants in and around the family room, and I thought the interior design was on point, not to mention that beautiful rug there on the floor, and you have a lot of entertainment options there in the right-hand corner. To begin to wrap up in the family room, in that far corner for your entertainment, of course you have your large smart TV and it comes fully loaded with all of your usual streaming services like Netflix, Prime Video, and Disney Plus. If I open up one of the doors down here then, you'll find a bunch of games and other items. This is great for a family and kids, and you have some games like Taboo and Apples to Apples. That's about it for everything in this main area, so I'm now gonna switch gears to this other wing of the container home. But before we go to explore, I want to take a very quick break. Thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes. The platform will allow you to invest in yourself and to develop a specific skill. For me, that has been learning more about interior design, specifically terminology, because I kind of feel like I use the same like 3 words in a lot of my YouTube videos.
Incredible architectural gem, incredible treehouse, incredible tiny shipping container home.
I have been taking a class called Interior Design Basics with the instructor Lauren Cox. I was able to learn 4 key interior design principles like color, balance, scale and proportion, and rhythm and repetition. The class even showed real life examples like how to design a modern farmhouse. The first 1,000 of my viewers who sign up via the link in my description will get a 1-month trial of Skillshare so they can start to explore their creativity. So check out the link down below and let's now go and get back to the tour.
Back on the main floor of the container home, there are 3 doors. We're gonna go through the door on the far left, and this will take us into bedroom number 1 of 3 in this Airbnb. You have a simple bedding setup here with a little white table to the left of the bed and your air conditioning unit above. I think you can very clearly see the outline of a 40-foot container in this room. And if I slide back these two double doors, you have a large closet for storage. In the hallway again, the door on the far right is a closet, so we're now going to walk through the middle door, and this will take us into one of the bathrooms in this container home. It is very well equipped, as in they left you like 20 towels. There's a lot of towels waiting for you in this bathroom. You also, of course, then have your toilet and sink area here, more on the right hand side, and they even managed to fit in a washer and dryer unit into this bathroom. We've now covered everything on the main floor, so it's time to go upstairs. So I'm gonna head up and let's see what the second floor has to offer. This will take us into a long hallway, staring down one of the containers. Before we head in that direction, I'll go here to this bedroom at the top of the stairs. It's pretty similar to the other bedroom that we saw downstairs. You have another queen size mattress in here and some nice wall decorations. Let's now exit that bedroom and venture in this direction down the hallway to see what the other half of this top floor has. There is another rug very similar to what we saw earlier and a nice desk setup if you want to get some work done up here. But now take the camera and pan more to the left. You have those two bright white double doors and I'm going to open them up and this will take us to your large outdoor deck space. From this angle, you can see I'm now walking directly on top of one of the 40-foot containers. This outdoor space actually has some string lights. You can see them more towards the ceiling, so that's definitely nice to turn on later in the day. This is your seating area though. You have plenty of options like that larger bench, those two smaller chairs, and the three tables. Further down, you even have more chairs with cushions and another table for you. But this is a pretty sizable outdoor space. It's about the size of a 40-foot container for some reference, and it's just a great spot to relax in during your stay. Back inside, let's now check out the two final rooms in this Airbnb. If we go through this door to the left, this will take us into the kiddies room. They managed to squeeze in three bunk beds into this bedroom. This entire Airbnb can sleep up to 8 guests total. And I know you may be thinking it looks a little small, but even me, I'm about 6 feet, I managed to fit in just fine. Also, if you pan more to the right, you have this black shelf with a few baskets that you can use for storage. Now we'll turn our attention to the final room. So we're gonna head through this door on the right-hand side, and this will take us into the second bathroom in this container home. There are some similarities to the bathroom that we saw downstairs, but this one felt a little more spacious to me. I think because there is not a washer and dryer unit in here. Instead, you have a bunch of extra cabinets, which leaves more room for storage. If I pull back this curtain then, you can find a simple bathtub and shower. And now along this wall, you have some bright white cabinets and your sink. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.